Hello.
Good morning.
Selma Blair. Selma Blair came out with her MS diagnosis a couple years ago in 2018, so about a year ago, and she's just finished a really aggressive round of treatment, and she celebrated by shaving her head and posting it on Instagram. It's not clear if she needed to shave her head for the treatment or if it's something she did to mark the milestone. She's very optimistic that this treatment will have an impact on her disease. She's very thankful to her legion of friends and family who have been supportive of her through this. It's a horrific, debilitating disease, MS is, and I think it makes a world of difference to see somebody like Selma when she came at the Oscars at the Vanity Fair carpet with her cane, with her speech, her now impeded, and to see her living the best life she can with this disease and being positive about moving forward with it.
Well, it brings it into the normal, right?
Absolutely.
And lets people see it and talk about it and embrace what's going on and help her. And support.
Yes, and in following that journey too, right? Because, like you said, she came out with her diagnosis in 2018. It does not end there.
No.
Right? There is so much more that needs to be done when it comes to treatment. So anyone who might be going through it, someone, maybe a loved one who has a family member going through it, they can understand the process of it
and
all.
And show the progression of the disease and show what it means. And she's very clear that she has good days and bad days. She's very clear that there's sometimes she just has to pull away and take care of herself. She gets tired. Some things she can't face in the same way she used to, but really, really kudos to her for being as public as she is with it, because I can't imagine how challenging that would be. But finished a really aggressive round of treatment. Let's hope that that has a huge impact on her and the progression of the disease.
She's immunosuppressed for the next few months.
Yes.
So
she said, I can't hug and
treatment.
I can't kiss for the next couple months.
Which is
so
tough.
Gwyneth Paltrow, who, you know, has been in the public eye for so long and has been heralded as such a beautiful woman for her entire life. And now at 46 years old, she is addressing getting older and what that impact is on her. As I said, she's 46. She talked about this on the Goop podcast. Of course, Goop is her company that she founded with
her thing.
And she said, I've always felt so funny about my looks. I think that it's very rare to think that you're a beautiful person. And so I feel like every other woman. I don't see that when I look in the mirror. And, you know, I guess it's interesting for her, for somebody who has been, like, put on a pedestal of, you know, the absolutely beautiful woman, to age in the public and to kind of disappear. And she said, you know, what happens to your identity as a woman if you're not beautiful? And so I think that it's interesting. You know, we were talking about this earlier, and Roger, you're like, I think Helen Mirren is beautiful.
Absolutely. Dame Judi Dench, but they're incredible at what they do.
Yes. Right? Yeah. And so all.
And that's what comes through.
And age is a funny thing. I think that, you know, certainly I'm going to be 48 in October, and certainly my idea of what I thought 48 was going to be is not what it's going to be. Almost 48 is pretty good.
It's phenomenal.
You know?
Yeah.
And so I'm embracing getting older, and Gwyneth ultimately says, it's like you feel so good, you know who you are, hopefully you value the relationships in your life and your work and your contributions to the world.
Well, and that's the biggest thing, right? It goes beyond it. You break free from that. I think it's tough for some beautiful women because they get caught in that expectation of what they're supposed to be and what they're supposed to look like.
Yeah, that's exactly what she said. Put in a box.
That's it.
Yep. Coming up, Backstreet's back, guys.
Yes.
Yeah, we got Heidi talking about a solo project, talking about Backstreet. It's a really fun interview.
Good stuff. Thanks, Tara.
Let's head down to Tim.